Welcome back. I have shown ODE-based models for cell cycle, gene expression, and cell fate determination. However, I did not explain those equations. You must be wondering how I constructed those ODEs for those models. In this video, I will explain how we develop ODE-based models for molecular processes in a cell. I will focus on cell signaling and gene expression. Cell signaling starts with a ligand binding to its receptor on the cell surface. That triggers a cascade of enzymatic reactions. Eventually, the signal reaches the nucleus and triggers the expression of the target genes. We can break this whole process into a few elementary processes. Interaction of the ligand to the receptor, enzymatic reaction, and transcription and translation. We will learn to model each of these elementary processes one by one. A ligand binds to its receptor to form a complex. This is a bidirectional process. The ligand binds to the receptor through non-covalent interactions, and due to thermal fluctuations, the complex also dissociates to give rise to free ligand and free receptor. We can use the law of mass action here. For example, dL/dt is equal to minus K1 into L into R plus K2 into LR. K1 into L into R is for binding, and K2 into LR is for the unbinding. L and R are the concentration of the free ligand and receptor. We can write similar ODEs for R and the complex LR. Usually, K1 and K2 are not measured separately in experiments. Instead, one measures the affinity of the ligand in terms of the dissociation constant KD. The dissociation constant is the inverse of the equilibrium constant. By definition, KD is equal to L into R divided by the concentration of LR, the complex. Remember, L and R are the concentration of the free ligand and free receptor at equilibrium, and LR is the concentration of the complex at equilibrium. A receptor can bind to more than one ligand. Here I have shown a bivalent receptor. For example, imagine an antibody. It has two arms to bind to two antigens. Binding of a monovalent ligand to a bivalent receptor can be broken down in steps. First, one ligand binds to create LR complex. Then the other one binds to create LRL complex. We will use the law of mass action again. Here is the ODE for the first complex LR. Note one issue very carefully. The ligand can bind to any of the two arms. So the rate of production of LR is doubled. Similarly, LRL has two ligands. Any of those two can dissociate to create LR. So we have a doubled rate of this dissociation. And then we have the ODE for LRL complex. When the ligand is bivalent or multivalent, the stoichiometry of binding and unbinding can get very complicated. You need to keep track of all possible ways a complex can form and break. In an enzymatic reaction, a substrate is converted to a product in the presence of an enzyme. If we simplify the process, we can imagine it as a second order reaction and write the ODE using the law of mass action. But remember, the concentration of the enzyme will not get affected by this reaction. In reality, an enzymatic reaction is a multi-step process. It has two intermediates, substrate enzyme complex and product enzyme complex. We can simplify this scheme by making two assumptions. Consider both the intermediate complexes are one single entity, C. And consider that C to P conversion is not reversible. Now we can write four ODEs for four components. In models for cell signaling, we will have a large number of enzymatic reactions. If we have n number of enzymatic steps, then we will have 4n number of ODEs. That increases the complexity of the model. To reduce the number of ODEs and parameters in the model, we often use Michaelis-Menten equation. Here we assume that C is at a quasi-steady state. This assumption is valid only when the total concentration of the enzyme ET is much, much smaller than the total substrate concentration plus K2 plus K3 divided by K1. In essence, you can say the total enzyme concentration is very low with respect to total substrate concentration. With this assumption, we can write dpdt is equal to K3 into ET into S. S is the concentration of free substrate divided by K2 plus K3 divided by K1 plus S. Now replace K3 into ET by Vmax and K2 plus K3 divided by K1 by Km, the Michaelis-Menten constant. Values of K3 and Km are known for many enzymatic reactions. That makes our modeling more realistic. But be careful, the assumption of Michaelis-Menten kinetic is not valid in many biological systems. Gene expression is a multi-step process that involves a large number of different molecules. Keeping the bells and whistles away, we can imagine it as a three-step process. First, generation of mRNA by transcription. Sometime a signal would control that process. Transcription is followed by the translation, and both protein and mRNA get degraded with time. In many inducible systems, induction of transcription follows a sigmoidal behavior. For example, if you induce a lac operon by IPTG, you will notice that the transcription is very low at a low dose of IPTG. However, after crossing a threshold dose of IPTG, transcription increases enormously. While writing the ODEs for gene expression, we try to capture that threshold or sigmoidal behavior. Here is our system of ODEs for an inducible system. M is mRNA, P is protein. KB is the rate of basal or leaky expression that happens even in the absence of an inducing signal. Km into M is the rate of degradation of mRNA. The middle component is for the induction of transcription by the signal S. And for that, we are using a Hill function. Hill function is widely used to capture the threshold or sigmoidal behavior observed in many systems with cooperativity. We know that transcription factors have cooperativity. The general form of Hill function is y equal to x to the power n divided by k to the power n plus x to the power n. N is the Hill coefficient and k is the Hill constant. For x greater equal to 0, y varies between 0 to 1. Let's check how n and k affect the function. Hill coefficient is a measure of cooperativity. When n equal to 1, we get a rectangular hyperbola. When n is greater than 1, we get sigmoid. When n is very high, the sigmoidal curve changes very sharp and behaves like a switch. The Hill constant k determines the value of x for which y is half saturated. Some transcription factors inhibit gene expression. Often such inhibition also shows a sigmoidal behavior. For this, we use inverse Hill function, y equal to k to the power n divided by k to the power n plus x to the power n. The properties of inverse Hill function are same as that of the Hill function, only y decreases with an increase in x. Now let's get back to our original ODEs. The second ODE is for protein. KL into M is the rate of translation and KP into P is the rate of degradation of the protein. We can combine these two ODEs to create a single ODE. Assume transcription is very fast and reaches a steady state much before translation. Assume steady state for mRNA and calculate the steady state value of M. Now plug that steady state value of M into the ODE for the protein. We will club multiple constants to create new ones. So we get our final ODE. dpdt is equal to QB plus QS into the Hill function, s to the power n divided by k to the power n plus s to the power n. minus Kp into P. Now you know the functions and forms of ODEs used for these processes. You can combine them as and when required to create an ODE-based model. Let's go back to our model for self-fed determination. We have not considered transcription and translation separately, both are combined. X induces its own expression, but Y inhibits the expression of X. So we have a Hill function for autoinduction and an inverse Hill function for inhibition. The last part is for degradation. We use the same formulation for Y. In this video, we have learned to create ODE-based model for a few elementary processes. We use the law of mass action to model ligand-receptor interaction. For an enzymatic reaction, you can write a system of ODEs considering all the intermediate steps explicitly. But that may increase the complexity of the model. To reduce the number of ODEs and parameters, you may use Michaelis-Menten equation. Gene expression is modulated by transcription factors and inducing signals. To capture the effect of such a signal, use Hill function. For inhibitory signals, use the inverse Hill function. That's all for this video. I hope now you can combine these equations and functions to create your own ODE-based model for cellular processes. Thank you for learning with me.